my feel good breakfast
show. Welcome back, you beauty.
Yep.
I've still got goosebumps, dude. I'm going to be like that the whole day. I'm sorry.
Remember what you said at the beginning of the show?
Yeah.
You were like, you get that feeling. It's going to be one of the
good ones. It's a vibe.
It's a good one. It's a good one. And indeed, woo! It is. Cannot wait to hear the music coming up. Do not miss out on that. Now, listen up. Of course, something else that's pretty big that's been happening out in the States. This year's BET Hip Hop Awards brought the hottest names in hip hop back to Atlanta, Georgia this Tuesday for the annual taping of the Trailblazing Award Show.
Our very own Nadia Nakai, Black Sharif, Burna Boy, Blackie and Tim Sweater among Africa's nominees, and of course Grammy-nominated recording artist and media personality Fat Joe hosted this year's awards from the Cobb Energy Center. Let's take a little sneak peek.
Joe Cracks here, let's take it to old Atlanta.
Wow.
Effortlessly cool, right?
Hey.
It's something to do with that bald head and beard combo.
Having like pyrotechnics and dancers and a marching band behind you, the drum line, absolute stroke of brilliance, I think. Beautiful stuff, man.
Absolutely. So entertainment reporter Jen Su had the exclusive privilege of sitting down with Fat Joe one-on-one, chatting about the passing, of course, of rapper Ricky Rick, as well as his love for Mzansi. Let's take a look.
First of all, I want to say rest in peace to Rick. Suicide, you know, you have to be in a really, really dark place to do that. And it's not talked about enough in our community. And it's really, really happening. And so we got to shine a light on that and tell anybody, because you never know what anybody's going through. So if you need help, please seek help. Please tell your friends. Please tell your family. Hey, I need a life preserver. Somebody come talk to me. South Africa is one of my most favorite places on earth. It's top three. So when they ask me, I always go, there's an island called Cat Cay in the Bahamas. There's Dubai and there's South Africa. Those are my three top places in the world.
Wow. I mean, you know, when you live in South Africa, you must be grateful for these things.
Completely, but I think the eyes of the world clearly here, which is absolutely beautiful. We love that.
A
big night for some artists, none more so than Kendrick Lamar. He ruled the night. Six wins, including Artist of the Year, Lyricist of the Year, Best Live Performer, along with Album of the Year. I don't know which out of those he would be most happy with, but some major, major awards won in the evening. Wow.
Absolutely. And of course, you saw it a little bit there. Drake did take home three wins, including Best Collaboration for Wait For You with Future and Thames. And of course, a nod to the talent coming out of the motherland as well. And in another victory for female rap newcomer, Glorilla took home the award for Best Breakthrough Hip Hop Artist. Let's see why.
Demi, I ain't got a word by no G. And I'm S-I-N-G-L-E-L-E. Outside hanging out the window with my ratchet. From the good.
Okay, it's not the first time you've seen that on Breakfast TV. Get over it, man. Just get over it.
When last did you drop it low like that? I just want to know.
Kind of every Friday, isn't that the vibe, dude?
That's kind of
the vibe, yeah.
This is also true.
Of course, the award show was only part of what made the night so epic. And now bringing you exclusive red carpet coverage is our lady in red, the one and only Jen Su. Take it away, girl.
Hey there, and a very good morning, Expresso. I'm Jen Su, right here at the BET Hip Hop 2022 Awards. Wow, it's a gorgeous red carpet. And of course, we've got Fat Joe hosting for the very first time, Nadia Nakai and Blackie as nominees, and a posthumous award to Ricky Rick. Let's check out the highlights.
Shout out to Cape Town. Yeah, I mean, South Africa, Wagwan. We Dead Prez. My name is M1.
I'm Stick.
Yep. And we're here to rock your world.
How you doing? It's DJ EFN, one half of the Drink Champs, and you're watching Expresso South Africa. Yeah, so I have a documentary series where I travel to different countries and I explore the country through hip-hop culture. And our last film, our sixth film that we did, was in South Africa. We went to Cape Town and Johannesburg.
I'm going to South Africa in February, and I couldn't be more excited. I want that day to come tomorrow.
You know, I'm waiting to see somebody that, you know, I have a little crush on, but, you know.
Who's that? Let us know.
Cordae Black. Okay. Cordae Black, hi. Trina getting her flowers, and Glorilla and Cardi B performing.
Well, have a great night tonight. You are here at the BET Hip Hop 22.
I'm most excited to see Fat Joe. He's from the Bronx. I'm from the Bronx. And he's hosting.
It is going to be an amazing night in honor of hip hop and all of its influence on culture as a whole, but definitely Black culture. So.
And there you have it from the BET Hip Hop Awards 2022. I'm Jen Su. Now back to you guys in the Expresso studio.
Oh, we had to have a little shimmy there just to round it off. Jen Su, you are amazing. Thank you so much for bringing us the latest inspiring stuff. And I know as much as Mzansi maybe didn't get the award, it felt like we were so well represented, and I'm so glad that they paid homage to Ricky Rick, man.
Yeah, and as a continent as well, we were just talking about it right now, how some of our iconic kind of, you know, markers, if you will, like you were talking about DJ Khaled rocking Masandawana jersey. You're like, come on, that is amazing out there. So recognition for the continent at large, and we love to see it. So shout out to everyone out there who is, you know, paying homage to where it's happening right now. Africa, your time is now! Ow!